guys, hope you're well. Welcome back to another collection update video. It's been about a year and a half since my last one. I think December 2019 was my last update video. And since then I've collected films, put them on the shelf, and then you just sort of forget about them. But as I say, the addiction is real. The collection is expanding. I even bought myself a new shelf to put some independent labels on. Behind me, this wasn't there in the last update video. But in this update, got a few titles, well, more than a few. Two packages from my good friends here on YouTube, Jase over in Perth, my neighbour I like to say, and CultureTrini over in the US. They'll both help me out with titles that aren't available here, and sales in the US that don't ship to Australia. So, you know, big help to those guys. Great friends here on YouTube, and just really appreciate it, guys. So this is going to be a pretty long one, guys. Go grab yourself a drink, food, whatever you're eating. Sit back and relax, and enjoy. Now, the first few titles I'm going to show you here are from my good friend Jase, really good friend of mine here on YouTube, and sent these in the kindness of his own heart. Really do appreciate them. Thanks, Jase. So I got Twilight Times release of Ombre. Now, I'm a big Paul Newman fan, you know, love his films. There's still a few more I need to watch. But I watched his recently the other day, and great film here, great little Western. It's actually a Twilight Time release, and this is actually my first Twilight Time title. So I think they're out of print now, so a lot of these titles, the whole company's down, I'm pretty sure. But I know a few of them being re-released on Kino Lorber, so a great one to start out with. We're going to make a new section, new shelf here, and start my Twilight Times. But great film. Highly recommend it to any Paul Newman lover, any Western lover. Great film here. Next one up is a Korean film. This director wrote the screenplay for I Saw the Devil. So this is a New World and Eureka title, a Korean gangster film. Looks very interesting, so can't wait to check this one out. Looks pretty good. This is two DVDs here, Glenn Gary and Glenn Ross. This one looks great. The cast look fantastic. Got Al Pacino, Jack Lemmon, Alec Baldwin, Ed Harris, and Alan Arkin, and Kevin Spacey. So, it looks interesting. Can't wait to check it out. And next one up is a spaghetti western. I've been getting into a lot of the whole western genre. I like exploring new films. Bullet for the General. Can't wait to check this one out. As I said, just been seeking out some new spaghetti western films and western films. I got a few to show you throughout the video, but this one looks like fun. So thanks, Jase, for sending me these. I can't thank you enough. So that's them. So a few sales in the US happened. We got Kino Lorber, the 4 for $40 Warner Archive, which is the last one. We have Hamilton Book and a few Screen Factory. So started with the Kino Lorber titles. So good titles here. So Adios Sabata, this is the second Sabata film with Yul Brynner. Shame about the first one's now out of print. Would have loved to have all three, but I'll try to find it. I'm on the hunt for it. And then the third Sabata film with Lee Van Cleef. Yul Brynner again, Invitation to a Gunfighter. Kirk Douglas in Lonely Are the Brave. Marlon Brando in The Apollo Loser. Lee Van Cleef in Captain Apache. Burt Lancaster in Apache. Yeah. Young Billy Young. Thunderbirds Are Go and Thunderbirds 6, the two feature films made in the 60s. I used to watch these all the time as a kid. I got the whole Thunderbirds collection down there in the DVD collection, and they're great. They're always just nostalgic to me. Even the 2004 movie was, it wasn't great, but it was it's fun, I guess. Really like the Thunderbirds. Yeah, good stuff. And this is a comedy I used to watch all the time. Michael J. Fox in Life with Mikey. Just a fun film here, you know, really really good stuff, and just a funny family comedy. Really enjoy it. Roger Moore in Gold. Roger Moore again in The Naked Face. We got a Paul Newman film, The Secret War of Harry Frigg. Eddie Murphy, got a few Eddie Murphy titles, Holy Man. And that's it for the Kino Lorber title, so pretty good stack there. A few there I haven't seen, and I'm excited to check out. So, Kino Lorber. And next is a 4 for $44 sale. I think it was the last one. Someone else has taken over the distribution of the Warner Brother or the Warner Archive titles. So we got Richard Harrison, Man in the Wilderness. I think this is the second film in the John Ford trilogy, John Wayne trilogy. She wore a yellow ribbon. Robert Redford in Jeremiah Johnson. Richard Harris again in The Deadly Trackers. Jackie Chan, Mr. Nice Guy. Been building up my Jackie Chan collection because, yeah, great films and, yeah, love my martial arts stuff. So, yeah, Mr. Nice Guy. Steve Martin, Rick Moranis in My Blue Heaven. Spencer Tracy in Father of the Bride. I like this one. I like the remake as well with Steve Martin. Yeah, great films. Another Spencer Tracy title, Bad Day at Black Rock. And that's it for the Warner Archive title. So yeah, pretty nice stack there. And then Hamilton Book, we're having a sale. Just got all these titles that are just random titles that are, you know, cheap. Here we got John Wayne and William Holden in The Horse Soldiers. Four timeless westerns. This was like, you know, $8-$9 for four westerns, and you know, that's a bargain on Blue. And on here we have Rio Conchos, Take a Hard Ride, Butch and Sundance Early Years, which I'm looking forward to watch. The Last Hard Men. And even if the films are bad, you know, for $8-$9, four westerns, can't go wrong. Mick Lintock, John Wayne. The remake of Rollerball. I remember seeing this as a little kid, and I know there's an original, I think the original's James Caan, pretty sure. Yeah, always fun. LL Cool J in there as well. And this one I really like. This is a martial arts film, The Protector. I've got the sequel because this one's not available on Blu-ray here for some reason. But yeah, both fun martial art films. Tony Jaa, I think. Yep. Here we got a Chuck Norris 3 film collection. Should be fun. The Delta Force, Missing in Action, and Missing in Action 2, The Beginning. So, you know, fun Chuck Norris films here, so why not? And the Harrison Ford 5 film collection, The Frantic, Presumed Innocent, The Fugitive, Firewall, and 42. So, yeah, this was like $10, so why not for Harrison Ford? Can't go wrong. And here, I'm looking forward to checking this one out. This is Woodstock, the director's cut, 3 days of peace and music. Always loved the Woodstock concert. Some great artists in here, you know, you've got Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, Canned Heat. Everyone of everyone was here. I think Joe Cocker as well. So yeah, some great music. I'll put this on one day and just blast in the speakers. This would be great. So can't wait to check this one out. Dr. Zhivago, Robert De Niro and Edward Norton in The Score. This is a double feature. Already had Snake. Already had Face Off, but this came with Snake Eyes. So Face Off and Snake Eyes, Nicolas Cage double feature. So it's cool. And this one I've always wanted to check out. It's called No Way Back. Russell Crowe. Russell Crowe, one of his first action films. I think it was made in like 95, maybe 94, 95. So yeah, no, good stuff. No Way Back. We got Paul Hogan and Elijah Wood in Flipper. This was like $4, so why not, my man? Paul Hogan, the Aussie. And then we got Patrick Swayze in Roadhouse. This is a Shout Select title. So. Yeah, happy to own this one. And last but not least, Gone with the Wind. This was going for like $70, $80, and on Hamilton Book it was like $7, $8. So it's just crazy how things go, you know, off streaming services, and then, you know, the physical media goes up. But pretty sure you can still get this, you know, somewhere. I don't know, $80 for the film. It was crazy. But yeah, $7, $8. Glad I got this on Blu-ray finally. I've never seen it, but yeah, it's an epic. I've heard a lot of things about it, so. Yeah, can't wait to check out. So they're the Hamilton Book. And then I said to Trini, you know, I got my titles there, but these two are just going so cheap on Amazon. I thought, I've got to have them in the collection. That's the Scream Factory set of The Omen. You get all five films, just including the remake and even the fourth TV movie. I don't think it's been released on Blu-ray ever. So yeah, great set here. This is, you know, still sealed. Can't wait to crack into this in October. The first one's great with Edgar Allan Poe, and even the sequels are just, you know, they're kind of fun. And I do own the first Blu-ray, the Australian trilogy that came out, but these are all being, I think at least the first one's been remastered in 4K. So yeah, it'd be great to check out. So The Omen set, great films. And then we have the Fly collection. So the five films that you get. The Fly, Return of the Fly, Curse of the Fly, and the Fly remake, and then the Fly, the second film. So yeah, great sets here, fantastic sets. Even the artwork's great. You know, just happy to own them. So thanks Trini for that lot, really do appreciate it. Can't thank you enough, guys. And Jase, can't thank you enough, you know, really do appreciate it. Awesome, guys, thanks a lot. Now we get into some JB Hi-Fi pickups. I picked up the Classics Remastered, John Carpenter, Escape from New York, Prince of Darkness, The Fog, and They Live. For some reason, this is now out of print, and they were selling them, they were clearing them out for $20, so why not? I think the DVD was $25, the Blu-ray was like $40, and this original price was, I think, $75, $80, so for $20 for four 4K films, that's fantastic, and they're great films as well. And then I bought separately Escape from New York and Escape from LA. I couldn't have LA on the shelf without New York sitting next to it. So two fun films here. First one's great, the second one not so much, but you know, they're fun. And then we have the new edition, because I think the first Sony release is out of print, of Jerry Maguire. Got a few more Tom Cruise films to buy, so Jerry Maguire. Next one up, Eric Bana in Munich. Haven't seen this in ages, so this would be a good one to check out again. Papillion. Steve McQueen and Dustin Hoffman. I'm going to say Steve Martin. Haven't seen this, so be one to check out. Breakfast at Tiffany's, it's a classic. The Borrowers, I found out I bought this and I found out I already own it. So, The Borrowers. My Brother, We're Out There, this is one Coen Brothers film I haven't seen. I think I've got about three left to watch. So, one to check out. And Jase actually recommended this one to me. And of course, I like, you know, Robert Redford films. So, 3 Days of the Condor. This is a new release here at JB. It's been Classics Remastered, so it's been remastered. I forget who brought out there is a Blu-ray of this, another Blu-ray. I forget who brought it out, but if you want to check it out, Robert Redford, 3 Days of the Condor. And onto the local seller titles. This person imports, you know, Blu-rays, 4Ks, and some of these aren't available here, so it's great to own them. So we have The Deer Hunter. I own this on Blu-ray, but at a 4K with the slip, it'd be great to rewatch. Next up here we have Beverly Hills Cop in 4K. This is always a fun film. Now where's the second and third one, Paramount? And here we have 48 Hours and another 48 Hours. These two are just fun, you know, buddy films. Just good stuff. And I'm so glad they got this one especially got a Blu-ray release. This one did have one. I had the Australian one. So glad they've been both remastered in 4K. The Paramount Presents line, they do an excellent job at, you know, with artwork and remastering them. You get the original artwork there. Same with another 48 Hours. You guys have probably seen this, but two great films here and good stuff. Next we have the Blu-ray of The Golden Child, another Paramount Presents title. Fun stuff. Next one up, Nobody. I haven't seen this one yet. I'm bound to check it out. Next one up, Godzilla and King Kong. Haven't seen this one yet. I've heard mixed things, but we'll see how we go with it. And this one was a really great film from last year. Kevin Costner, Diane Lane in Let Him Go. Sort of like a 50s western. It does play out like a western film. Great film, very powerful film as well. Total Recall. I've got the Blu-ray of this, and this will be a good upgrade. We have Kick-Ass, got the Blu-ray, but why not? Thought it'd be a good upgrade. And then we have the 4K of Mad Max, the Kino Lorber actually. With the slip. Great film, and can't wait to check it out on 4K. And this person threw this in for free. It wasn't great, but also wasn't bad either. It was just sort of okay. It's the little things. I think Denzel and Jared Leto did a great job. I feel that anyone could have really played Rami Malek's character. That's just me. But Denzel and Jared Leto, did great in it. And it's just an okay film. It sort of led up to this big ending and was like just sort of just fell flat. Don't want to spoil anything, but the little things. On to the local sellers again. This local seller is selling a few titles I bought for cheap. We have The Assassination of Jesse James, Brad Pitt, and then these films that aren't available here. So I was very happy to get them. We have Napoleon Dynamite, always a fun one. Secondhand Lions with Michael Caine, Robert Duvall. The Quick and the Dead. Sleepy Hollow. And Three Kings. Now onto the eBay portion, we have Arthur and Arthur 2 on the rocks, Dudley Moore classics, can't go wrong. I think he's hilarious. And even the remake wasn't bad with Russell Brand. I think, you know, they're fun films. Fun little comedies here. So, yeah, Arthur 1 and 2. Jack Nicholson, About Schmidt. The West Side Story, just in time for the new, I think it's a remake that's coming out at the end of the year. So I actually haven't seen this. I do like a good musical every now and then. So West Side Story. Comedy double feature. Again, these aren't available here. So Miss Congeniality 1 and 2. Then we have Sanity. I bought these online for a buy 2 get 1 free. And movies I didn't buy day 1, but I really liked, you know, two films here from last year. We have Eric Banner in The Dry. This is a great, you know, murder mystery film, you know, that's, you know, set in the present and set in the past, and the two link up with one another. Yeah, great film here, The Dry, great little, you know, murder mystery here. And then we have Kerry Mulligan in Promising Young Woman. Really enjoyed this one, and yeah, happy to have it on Blu-ray. And then this was the free title, you know, Robert De Niro, Mickey Rourke in Angel Heart. Haven't seen this one, but I really want to check it out, so glad I got it. And next up, we have some Imprint reviews. Now, Imprint are the new company by ViaVision. They release titles that aren't on Blu-ray, and it's a really an Aussie first. So I'm glad to say that we have a label here now. You know, America's got Criterion, a UK Arrow. You know, this can go on, but yeah, I'm glad that we have we got Umbrella, and then we also got this new one releasing films. You know, Australian first. You know, Blu-ray. So. Let's get on to them. I'm going to review a few of them as well, so let's do it. And all these titles come with slip packages, and they are numbered spine, so yeah, they definitely put some effort into these releases, which is great. And that is War of the Worlds, the first title here. Now, I remember watching this after I saw the remake when it first came out with Tom Cruise, and I remember watching it and thinking it's just not as good as the remake, I don't know, just young self. And I still reckon the remake beats this. You know, it's just it's a little outdated, but it's a fun film. You know, fun little sci-fi film. I do a double feature, this one and the remake, very soon. So I haven't opened this one yet, so War of the Worlds. Next one up is number 4 here. The Duelist, Ridley Scott. Got Harvey Keitel in this, and this is Ridley Scott's first film. And it's a pretty decent film. You know, I enjoyed it. This one up here, number 7. Rod Steiger and George Segal in No Way to Treat a Lady, and this is sort of like a cat and mouse sort of you know, thriller here. I actually found myself, you know, just laughing in a few spots. I don't know what it is. I just found myself, you know, laughing, and it was really weird. Rod Steiger plays this killer who starts, you know, killing off you know, women in the neighborhood, and George Segal plays this cop who sort of lives with his mum, and you know, he's chasing him. So, you know, just cat and mouse story there. There's No Way to Treat a Lady. Really enjoyed the film. You know, this is the first time it's been released on Blu-ray. I highly recommend it. We have Andy Garcia and Richard Dreyfuss in Night Falls on Manhattan. And this is one of Sidney Lumet's later films. I think this was in the early 90s. Sorry, 96. And it's number 10 of the Imprint collection. Yeah, I thoroughly enjoyed it. I really like Andy Garcia in really any role he does. I like him in Black Rain, I think it is, as well. And of course, Vincent Corleone in Godfather Part 3. He was cool in that. But yeah, really like Andy Garcia. And the film was okay. I you know, enjoyed it. It probably could be just a one-time watch for me, though. But I enjoyed it for what it was. Night Falls on Manhattan. And next up here, we have Sam Peckinpah's third directed film. Charles Heston, Richard Harris in Major Dundee. And this is number 11 of the Imprint titles. And this is a great set here. Both the theatrical cut and extended cut have been remastered in 4K. Yeah, nice little box here, and two cases. You got the extended version there. It's awesome, and then you got the theatrical version there. Now, I saw the theatrical version. It was sort of just okay. You know, you sort of had a big build up to the ending, and the ending was sort of like ah. But it's something I want to go back to and watch the extended version. And next up here, when I heard this film was going to be released in Imprint, I just went, you know, crazy. This is one I was very anticipated for. Paul Thomas Anderson's Hard Eight. This is his first film, number 14 of the Imprint collection, made in 96. This film sets up what's about to come with Paul Thomas Anderson's films. Recurring themes, recurring actors. You got Philip Baker Hall, John C. Reilly. You do get Gwyneth Paltrow. I don't think she's in any of his other films, but she did a good job in this regardless. And you even get Samuel Jackson, and you get Philip Seymour Hoffman, who appears in a few of PTA's films. So does John C. Reilly and Philip Baker Hall. So Hard Eight, real great film here. Kenneth Branigan and Emma Thompson in Dead Again, number 23. And this film was just sort of okay. It's a one-time watch. It's basically Emma Thompson's character. She basically loses her mind and starts having memories of the past. I just thought it was okay. Next one up here is Mickey Rourke in Year of the Dragon. Now, I know this had a Warner Archive release, and Year of the Dragon. And this film, it had a lot of potential, you know. I was really enjoying it, but it's sort of like a bland film. Even in the writing, it's just really bland. And Mickey Rourke, he looks like Bruce Willis in this movie. I don't know, I just kept seeing Bruce Willis. I had a bit of an issue with this disc. I leave my receiver on standard all the time, and that just, you know, covers everything. You get your dialogue in the center speakers, and then you get all your surround, you know, behind you, and of course in the front, left and right speakers. But for some reason, I was hearing voices in, you know, this speaker here. I don't know if the sound mix was way off on this release. I don't know what it was. It was really bugging me. I didn't really pick it up until about maybe half an hour into the film. But you know, it's a pretty long film, and yeah, I was just sitting here and I'm thinking, why am I hearing? I'm hearing, it's sort of like not an echo, but I was just hearing voices, and I was trying to play around the receiver. I didn't want to bother with it. I just wanted to sort of finish the film. But it's an okay film. It just had a lot of potential, and it just wasn't great. And next up here we have Sean Penn and Christopher Walken in At Close Range. This is number 25, and this was a really powerful film. Actually, Jase recommended this to me, and I really like Christopher Walken, and I really like Sean Penn. For some reason, this film had me thinking about it a lot after I saw it the next few days. I don't know if it was the music, you know, you get the Madonna theme in, Madonna Live to Tell, plays in the opening and the end credits. I highly recommend this, At Close Range. Great crime drama here. And next one up here is Fire in the Sky. This is number 26 of the Imprint titles. Based on the true story of Travis Walton, who was abducted by aliens in the 70s. The alien abduction itself, is great. I don't want to say too much if you haven't seen it, but the last half an hour of this film is really where it shines. I really enjoyed it. You've got Robert Patrick in here from T2. Fire in the Sky. Here we have Nick Nolte in The Deep, and you also got Robert Shaw in this. I really like these sort of treasure films, treasure hunting films. It's a bit of a thriller as well. Thriller, a little bit of action in there. About this couple that goes scuba diving. They come across this old World War II ship that had sunk, and they find something in there that they shouldn't have. So that's all I'll say. And it's a really fun film. I enjoyed it. Thoroughly enjoyed it. The Deep. And next one up here, we have Kurt Russell in Breakdown. This is number 29 of the Imprint films. I had fun with this one. This is a really good film here, Breakdown. I think most of you have seen it. Actually, Trini and Jase recommended it to me. So, great film here, Breakdown. It has a 1080p presentation from the 4K scan that Paramount Pictures did. The film looks great. The sound is great. Breakdown. Next one up here, we have The Bridges at Toki Rai. This is number 30 of the Imprint films. You got really William Holden, Grace Kelly, and Mickey Rooney in here. This is like a Korean War film here. You get a little bit of action, then you got a little bit of story with William Holden and his family. William Holden and his wife and his family. A bit of a drama there as well. I really enjoyed this. This is something I'd definitely watch again. The next one up here is Walter Matthau in The Bad News Bears. This is number 31. This is a fun sporting film. I always like my, sort of underdog sporting films. I like Walter Matthau, grumpy old man and the odd couple. Really good stuff. And I had a lot of fun with this one. Very funny. And The Bad News Bears. Next one up here is Robert Duvall in The Apostle. So this is number 32. It's about a preacher that gets into a little bit of trouble. He then moves away and sort of starts his own church. And it's just something I want to watch again. It's probably just a one-time watch. Robert Duvall plays the preacher fantastic. Really great role for him, but it's just something I just wouldn't watch again. The Apostle. Next one up here is a 1951 film called Five. This is number 33. This is a post-apocalyptic film, with the only survivors, you name it, five survivors. Again, something I wouldn't watch again. For what it is, it's okay. In this one, you get a new 2K scan from the original negative. The film looks great, that's Five. Next one up here is another Robert Shaw Imprint film, where you have Black Sunday, and this is number 34 of the Imprint series. I really enjoyed this film. At first, I thought this was a disaster film. it's nothing like that. I really enjoyed it. It's sort of like an action thriller. You know, Robert Shaw has to stop this terrorist attack at the Super Bowl. You got Bruce Dern in here, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. Now these next four I haven't seen. We've got 35, 36, 39, and 40 of The Imprint. So 35, Richard Dreyfuss in Let It Ride. Looks like a fun comedy. Regarding Henry, Harrison Ford. 36, Harrison Ford regarding Henry. 39, The Mothman Prophecies with Richard Gere. Yep. And Paul Walker in Timeline, number 40. So haven't seen those yet. You have to check them out. So those four there. And next up we have What's It All About? Alfie. Michael Caine plays Alfie, you know, he's the ladies man, you know, a bit of a bachelor, and it's all the trouble he gets into with these women. I didn't really like his character. His character was a bit of an arsehole, but Michael Caine plays him great. The fourth wall interactions is great. I love that aspect of the film. But in this set here, it comes with two cases. You get the film itself, nice little artwork there. And then you get the 2017 documentary did My Generation. And this would be way up my alley. I still need to check this one out. I remember it being released. It's sort of like a documentary on the career in the 1960s through the eyes of Michael Caine. Always loved The Who. So My Generation, it looks like a great documentary. So that's Alfie and My Generation. And the next two up here, again, I haven't seen. We have The President's Analysis, number 42. This is the James Coburn film. I get to see it. It looks interesting. And then we have number 44, The Face Behind the Mask. Again, haven't seen it, but it looks good. Next up we have, I watched this the other night, James Caan. This is number 49, The Gambler. Now, I really enjoyed this film. You know, James Caan and what he goes through, you know, he's just the addiction. James Caan plays his teacher, a school teacher who then has a gambling addiction. And I really enjoyed it. It's probably one of James Caan's best roles as a leading man. Now, I haven't seen Thief yet either, so that's one of his later, in the 80s films. This is 1974, so great film here. I really enjoyed it. His character, even though he annoyed me, James Caan played him great. And I really enjoyed it, The Gambler. Hope you guys enjoyed my collection update. I really appreciate you guys checking in. Hope everyone stays safe. It's a crazy world out there these days. Stay safe and take care.